Setting up limits for your daily activities is crucial to ensure the safety and efficiency of your LinkedIn account. So let's navigate the ins and outs of mastering limits and delays in Linked Helper. To view and adjust your daily limit, navigate to the Settings menu, Limits section. LinkedIn monitors your daily activity, and exceeding certain limits can lead to restrictions no matter manually or via automation tools. That's why it's important to set up correct daily limits for Linked Helper. By default, the daily limit is set to 150 actions per day. It is a safe number for most users. Even though you can change this limit, it is not hard-coded. We do not recommend exceeding 150 actions. This limit is set for a reason. If you do a lot of actions in a short period of time, even manually, LinkedIn may send you a warning at best and restrict your account at worst. For new LinkedIn accounts, the limit should be much lower. Start from 10-15 actions per day, gradually increasing the number by 5 or 10 actions each week. If you reach the daily activity limit, Linked Helper will go to the sleeping state until the next credit is released. As you can see, Linked Helper performed 70 actions within the last 24 hours, hitting the limit as per my settings. The initial action from this count concluded at around 10 a.m. today. So the next slot will become available in 13 hours. Each action's reset occurs precisely 24 hours after it was initially performed. Every profile visit initiated by an action within your campaign's workflow is counted as part of the daily limit, as well as sending messages without profile navigation. But hold on! There are some actions that are not included in the overall daily limit, such as sending profiles to webhook or external CRM, checking for replies, searching for emails if you use Linked Helper email finder tool, and some others. But what if you want to limit specific actions within your account? For a more precise control, Linked Helper provides advanced limits. These allow you to set specific limits on activities such as inviting, messaging, liking, and more. Let's quickly look at some scenarios where advanced limits prove beneficial. For example, you can limit certain activity for a specific LinkedIn account. I've set a limit of 25 invites per 24 hours, so that I can reach the LinkedIn invitation limit by the weekends. Also, advanced limits can be useful for spreading activities throughout the day for better pacing. For example, I want Linked Helper to send messages to no more than 50 profiles per day. So I should add the limit of 50 actions per 24 hours for message to first connections activity type. At the same time, I do not want those 50 messages to be sent during 1 hour, so I should add another limit of 3 actions per 1 hour for message to first connections action. As a result, Linked Helper will be sending 3 messages each hour, but it will never send more than 50 messages per 24 hours. By setting up working hours in Linked Helper, you can make it work for this account only on certain days. Just toggle this button to make some days as working and some as non-working. You can also make Linked Helper work for this account only for a certain period of time. Just click on the plus button and add a working period. The schedule will be applied to all campaigns of the account. It is also possible to add several working periods for one day. Keep in mind that the time is shown for the selected time zone. Switching time zones won't change the actual start and stop times of working hours. It merely adjusts their representation. So if you want to change the working hours, you'll need to modify the values in the from to fields for certain days. When working hours can be useful? In case you manage someone else's account, parallel activity must be avoided. Naturally, no human is capable of inviting second-degree connections and sending follow-up messages at the same time. This behavior looks suspicious for LinkedIn. So, you can agree with your client on days and hours when you can work with their account, and set the slots by means of working hours in Linked Helper. Even if you manage only your own LinkedIn account, you can set working hours so that your manual working hours do not coincide with Linked Helper's campaigns. Now let's talk about customizing your delay settings. With Linked Helper, you have the flexibility to control how fast the tool processes profiles and the pauses between actions. This can be achieved if you install Action Steps Delays plugin. You can also find this plugin in the plugin store under Action Extensions tab. The bunch size defines how many profiles will be processed in one go before Linked Helper putting the action into a sleeping mode and moving to the next action. Timeout is time during which the action will stay inactive. Thus, when one action is on pause, Linked Helper switches to the other. So when the settings might be useful? For example, you run one campaign that involves inviting action, but you want to limit its activity to a certain number of invitations, let's say no more than 25 per day. In this case, you need to set bunch size for 5 profiles, followed by a 5-hour timeout or 300 minutes for the settings of timeout between bunches. In other words, it will take 24 hours to invite 25 profiles in this campaign.